welcome back to the channel. It's your girl Anna
and your boy Ant. You guys already know what's up.
And today we're coming back with another video. From the title of this video, you already know what's going down today. Today we're going to be doing a Q&A. I don't want to make this intro too long because we have so many questions.
How many questions?
It's so many, and I wish I can answer every single one of them. First of all, I want to say how much I love you guys, and I thank you guys all for the support, you know, the love and the support
awesome.
That you guys shown. You guys are literally our family. We love you guys so freaking much. Over the weekend, we asked you guys on Instagram to ask us questions because we'll be doing a Q&A, and we got a lot of questions.
We're excited to share with you guys and you know, give you guys our answers to all those questions. All right, y'all, so we're gonna start answering these questions.
I think this is the most appropriate one to start off with. How important is God in your life / relationship? I wanted to start off with this question because
that's a good question.
God is number one in our lives. That's why I asked this question first. He's very, very important in our relationship. I think that's one of the things that definitely has helped us. So for us, God is everything in our lives, and we're so grateful with him because he's the one that's blessed us and gave us this opportunity to live and to be in front of this camera right now.
Yeah.
So we're very grateful with God. And if you don't have God first in your life, then make God first in your life and you'll see how everything else falls through. Next question.
All right.
What's one memory with each other that you both will remember about each other for the rest of your life? It's really tough.
I mean, I feel like we've done so much stuff together.
We've
though,
done
so
everything,
so
everything
thing.
Together. So a little background story. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Oh, and by the way, make sure you hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. What are you waiting for to join the fam? So let's give y'all a second. Hold on. Give them a second, babe. You done?
I think I'm
done. Oh, okay, y'all done. Yay! Welcome to the family. Anthony and I are high school sweethearts. A lot of people say high school sweethearts don't last. We had ups and downs. We were very young, but we definitely been rocking with each other for 8 years. And those have been the best 8 years of my life. So we met each other when we were in high school. We lived in the same area and we went to high school together. I was a junior. He was a sophomore when we started dating.
Cougar, you over here looking for young
Don't play with me because that year I'm not that much older than you. I'm only like a year.
You're 2 years.
If anything,
older than me.
Like, babe.
You're like 3 years
older than me. Baby, stop. You lying. He lying. But anyways, so we were in high school, right after high school, and then we went off to college to live in Miami.
FIU Panthers.
Shout out. We traveled. We lived in Wisconsin, Indiana.
Before I met Anna, I was terrified of airplanes. Like, I never thought I would ever get on an airplane ever in my life. Like, if we were going somewhere out of state, like, if we were leaving Florida to go somewhere, it's going to be by car because I was not getting inside an airplane.
That was the fear he had, and I helped him conquer it.
Yep, so.
Anyways, before moving to Miami, because we did 2 years of college here in Tampa at our community college, and we went to live in Wisconsin for 2 months because there was, like, this program in college going on to be, like, a sales rep and stuff. So they paid for our housing in Wisconsin, and that was really, really fun. That was only 2 months, but it was awesome. We went to Indiana. We lived there for 2 months as well. Then we moved back, finally graduated from our community college, and then went and moved. I moved first to Miami, FIU, and then he moved.
Yep.
And then after that, we were there for 2 years. It was an amazing 2 years. You know, we grew closer. Going from high school to community college to university is like you can
and
really...
it's crazy. It's like we progressed up that staircase together.
Yeah, like we're like, yeah, we literally, yeah, like became adults together.
We kind of went on a big spiel because this does not answer the question. The question was, what was
no the, but wait the, I'm the telling them like a little background that. Information just in case they're new to the channel. But anyways, guys, he proposed to me back in 2017 when we graduated from FIU. I graduated with my bachelor's in PR. He did it in international business. When we graduated, we moved back home. In January, we bought our first home. So, yay! And then February, we got married. And that was, like, amazing, too. That would be another whole story time that we'll tell you guys details, and details. And, that was February, and then what else happened? Then obviously with this all corona stuff, we couldn't go on our honeymoon, but
yeah.
But anyways, we are going off in a tangent, but yeah, it's hard to say what's our favorite memory because they're all been beautiful.
If you had to choose, babe, what would it be?
Like,
if you had to choose one, what would it be?
My favorite memory, yeah, was our wedding day.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I love you, and like I kind of like I already knew it was official, but that day was like, wow, like I'm here. I'm actually your wife. Jones. I'm Miss Jones. Like, oh my, like, this is like for real. How about you? If you had to choose one memory.
Well, that's so funny that you say like our marriage, because I would have to say the first day that I seen you. So it's like, it's like the beginning is my favorite and then the ending is your favorite.
Well, it's not the ending.
It's not the ending, but it's, okay. You know, it's.
What do you mean the first day? Why is that the favorite memory?
Because it was the first time that I've seen the love of my life. That's why. The first time I laid eyes on the girl that I'm gonna be with for the rest of my life.
Didn't know that though. You didn't know that.
But you know what? I kind of felt something deep down in here that it was.
You knew I was gonna be your wife? Bro, we were like, I was 16. You were 15.
Okay, I didn't know he was gonna be my wife, but I knew he was gonna be something important to me. So.
Oh, I love you so much.
I love you too.
Alrighty, going on to the next question. In one word, how would you describe each other?
Beautiful. No, if I'm being real, in one word, caring.
Aw, caring. Why caring?
I always see you worry about things that aren't always about you. So you're not really selfish. Like, you work hard every single day. And it's not just for you, but it's for, like, your parents' business. You, like, have a dream to go and have your own foundation that you talk about all the time.
Yeah, guys, I have not to go in debt with that because I do want to have my own foundation.
Yeah, not for you, but to help other people who need the help. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So if I would have to say one word to describe you, it would be caring. And there's been many times when I've been down and you lift me up. And I you know.
If I describe you in one word, it would be ugly. Just kidding.
Wow, I'm done.
If I had to describe you in one word, I would describe you as amazing.
Amazing?
Yeah.
Why?
Because you're an amazing husband, you're an amazing son, grandson, friend, brother, relative, like, all the above. And everything, you're just amazing. I can continue on forever, y'all. Y'all know I like talking, so, like, this was, like, a bad idea doing a Q&A, because I'm gonna have you up all night. I'm gonna have y'all up all night. I'm gonna literally talk your ear off today.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so, yeah. Growing up, what was your dream job?
Elementary school, I wanted to be an astronaut.
What? And then you did tell me that.
And then I found out that you had to go into a rocket ship and go out of space, and that kind of scared me. So
wow. So you wanted to be an astronaut and not go out of space, babe? Like, come on.
I know, it don't make
You're
sense.
You're supposed to just sit in NASA and, like.
I mean, I thought you just go up into space, but I didn't even like airplanes back then. So what I look like inside a rocket ship. So I wanted to be an astronaut. And then I wanted to become a dentist. So I wanted to be an orthodontist. As time went on, I started getting into business and stuff like that.
That was your dream job though?
Yeah, I would say that was one of my dream jobs.
You don't remember what else was your dream job? Because you told me and I still remember. And you still want to do that.
I want to say it's my dream job. It's more like a passion, but I know what you're talking about. I want to have a chain of hotels, whether it's like a franchise or it's my own hotels that I start. But basically, I wanted to have these big hotels where I would go and I would help people who don't have jobs or are homeless, and then I would tell them, hey, whatever you need, I got you. If you need a place to stay, you can stay at the hotel and you can work and get money until you can get back on your feet. What about you?
So I thought deep down that I wanted to be part of the medical field.
What did you want to do?
I actually wanted to be an anesthesiologist, which is weird.
Oh, you knocking people out?
Yeah, so pretty much like I thought I was gonna do something in the medical field, and then I figured that's not the route I wanted to take. I love all my medical people, but you know, it wasn't for me. And then I realized that I wanted to be in the business world. So our next question is, have you ever been attached to someone before your relationship with Anthony? No. How about you, babe?
I never had a really deep, serious connection with anybody like that before you, babe.
Why Aunt doesn't speak Spanish?
Porque estoy not speaking Spanish. I was never taught Spanish growing up because I'm not Spanish.
So, it's so funny, guys. We say this like a million times.
Yeah, so I'm black and white. I'm not Spanish. I don't speak Spanish. I understand a little bit of it. And I do try and converse with your parents every now
guys,
and then.
Guys, comment below if y'all thought Anthony was Hispanic.
Yeah, no, I get Spanish all the time. But
everybody thinks he's Spanish.
It's really important to learn a second language, and I'm doing my best to try and learn Spanish. I want to learn other languages too. Like, I want to learn French. I want to learn
Mandarin.
I want to learn Mandarin, but that's going to take a while. But yeah, I want to learn a few languages. But Spanish is definitely first on my list. I've been learning a few words already.
And the second part of this question was, how does he communicate with Anna's parents?
So, like I said, I know basics. Like, I can have a basic conversation because I can understand a lot, but I can't speak it. I can't get my lips to get the words out like how I'm supposed to. But I do my best, and, you know, we use sign language sometimes or, like, gestures, so... You know,
and I help translate, babe. You forgot translate sometimes, about me. I'm a translator.
You're not always there. You're not always there, though. You're not always there. So,
okay.
You know. But no, we make it happen.
After y'all pranking each other, how long do you both stay mad for?
It depends on the prank.
There's I can stay mad for a whole day.
Whatever. You be crying.
Excuse me?
I'm playing.
That's a lie.
No, but actually, it depends. It depends on the prank. Like, the time that you pranked me about, cheating on me that one day.
Yeah.
I didn't really talk to you for that whole night.
But he was actually really upset.
I was okay in the morning though. So it's yeah. nothing. It's not
but
like
you
longer
know,
than
no,
the day.
At night we were fine.
It's never it like was, longer than the day.
At night we were fine though. We were fine. Because we can't really stay mad at each other, honestly, guys. Like 24 hours, like that doesn't exist with us, you know. Like,
and at the end of the day, it's just a prank, you know. So you gotta be mature.
So this is not part of the this is part of the question, but really quick, a really, really quick tip. When you're in a relationship, and especially if you guys are married or like in a really serious committed relationship, no matter what you guys go through, no matter if you guys fight and argue, don't go to sleep mad at your partner, because you never know what could happen. You can't take your loved ones for granted and life for granted. Every time me and Anthony get mad at each other, we get mad for a few hours. I might not talk to him. He annoys me. I annoy him. But by the end of the day, but by the end of the day, he already know what time it is.
What time is it?
If you could change one thing about each other, what would you change?
I don't think I'll change anything. I love who you are.
Really?
Yeah.
Stop.
No, for real.
Say something you would change about me.
Nothing.
I talk too much?
No, I mean, you're not perfect, but I love you and all your flaws.
Oh, you're so cute. You're lying, bro.
I'm not lying. I'm honest.
Really? Yeah. You love all my flaws?
Yeah.
All of them.
That's what makes you who you are.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, you're so cute. You're gonna make me cry, bro.
Stop.
I love you so much, babe.
What about me?
I would change nothing. Like, Anthony's not perfect, but exactly what you said, babe. Like, I wouldn't change nothing from you, because if I change something from you, then you wouldn't be you. Like, you would be someone else.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't want you to change it. Like, yeah, we can work on stuff. Everybody has things to work on. I have things to work on. You have things to work on. He has things to work on. We're not perfect, but I wouldn't just sit there and change him. Like, oh, I want him to do... No.
Yeah.
So, I love you for who you are.
I mean, you can play the game with me every now and then.
I mean, you can, you know, go do your nails with me, you know, like...
Well, let's go make it happen.
If they told you you have cancer and you only have 3 days to live, what would you do before you die? Love you guys. We love you too.
That's a really hard question.
That's really tough.
If it was me, honestly, I would just want to spend the last 3 days with my family.
Yeah.
That's what I would do.
To me, I would want to spend the day with my family, and I would want to try all the different foods there, like all the different restaurants. And I would want to go to like Busch Gardens and all the theme parks and drive all the crazy roller coasters.
I would do that too, because I'm afraid of roller coasters, but I would get on the one at Busch Gardens where you go all the way up and then it tilts you down to where you look at the ground. And you just drop.
Yeah, and if I knew I was going to be gone, I would also go out to the streets and, like, talk to homeless people and give them something to eat and kind of just, you know, just live it up. Just, you know.
You caring.
Oh, thank you. Well, stop. What are you guys going to do when all this coronavirus stops? We traveling. What's up? We going on a cruise, baby. With this coronavirus thing, we weren't even able to go on our honeymoon.
Yeah.
We were supposed to go on a cruise, all cute and stuff, and we couldn't even do that.
Definitely going on a cruise.
We're going on a freaking cruise. Who wants to come with us?
Yes, sir.
That would actually be so fun, babe.
Anton's like, Anna Cruise.
Hey, that would be so lit.
Anton's Royal Caribbean.
That's so lit. Do you remember the first song you guys dedicated to each other? Yes, I do. What is it?
It's
2 seconds. 1, 2.
Never End by Future.
Good job, baby. This will be a story time for another day. You know, we could do like a little mukbang and tell you guys about our story. But back in high school, my parents didn't approve of Anthony for certain reasons. And I'll tell you guys, I was too young. You know, I come from a Christian household. They're old school. They're Colombian. So they were very, like, strict on me. And, like, I couldn't date. I couldn't have a boyfriend. To make a long story short, there was a lot of people that didn't want to see us together. And it was hard in our relationship for, like, a few months. I would say, like, maybe, like, 6 months. It was really hard because, like, everybody was against us. We kind of, like, thought we shouldn't be together, but we loved each other so much. So there was a song that's called, go listen to it, it's called Never End by Future. It's like, we don't wanna never end.
Okay.
Hey, that's my song, babe. I love that freaking song. That's like, I listen to it and I literally think, like, I'm, like, 15 years old again with Anthony. 16, bro. Yeah. Would you guys leave each other for $1 million? A freak no. What kind of question is that? No.
You can't buy this. Like, they don't sell this at the store.
They don't sell this.
This is not available. Like, I don't know where you can buy this at.
Why would I leave him for $1 million? If anything, we're going to make $1 million together. What's up? Hey, guys, we're going to make $1 million together. Run up that check. Get the bag. Being popular on social media, do you guys find it stressing or hard sometimes to live a life without social media? Guys, social media can be very, very draining.
You guys, our family on YouTube, make it all the worthwhile for us. Whenever we get down, whenever we get overwhelmed with social media, I know for me, because I do a lot of the editing, there'll be certain days where I have to edit a video the same day that we record because we have to post that day. And it can be overwhelming at some times. But the fact that you guys are, I know that you guys are expecting a video from us, it motivates me to, you know, overcome that stress, overcome that being overwhelmed and finish doing that video for you guys. And at the end of it, when we post and I see that you guys are watching it, like, it makes me feel good because, like, you know, I didn't fail you guys.
So how do you guys not get over each other or, like, not get mad at each other really fast? So we keep our relationship fun.
Every day is a new day. We're always trying to do exciting things every day. With coronavirus, there's not so much we could do, but we try our best to, you know, at least, like, watch different shows or something. Yeah. Like, we get mad at each other. But it's not the fact of how to not get mad. It's how to overcome that when you guys are mad. How to put your differences aside. How to
put your pride to the side. Because men can be prideful. Girls can be prideful, too.
Put your pride to the side. Agree to disagree. And move forward. So, that's big. You have to understand how to do that. I feel like that's more important than trying to not be mad. Because you're going to get mad with people, especially when you're around them so much. So it's all about learning how to overcome those differences.
How many kids do you guys want in which genders?
5, 2 boys, 3 girls.
Dang, you already know. I want 6. 3 girls and 3 boys.
Ooh.
I want a big family, guys. Ooh. I want a big family. So stay tuned, because if you guys are part of the family now, you guys are gonna see all that. You're gonna see us grow and expand. I also want to adopt a kid, which I think I told you about this, like, briefly
a long time ago, yeah.
But I definitely want to adopt a child, because I feel like there's so many beautiful kids out there that don't have the opportunity.
Caring.
How did you meet, and how did you realize that he or she was the one?
So we met at a daycare. I worked there. She was volunteering.
I knew he was the one when in high school we were just, like, starting dating, and then I started seeing all his nice qualities, and I saw his goals, and I saw, like, he was so goal-driven, hardworking, dedicated, and loving, and I'm like, okay, this guy is perfect, and he's cute. So that's a plus, because it's not all about looks, y'all, but he's sexy, okay, and all the above. So to me, that was just like,
for me, it was like how you said earlier, when a lot of people didn't want to see us together and we were going through a really rough time in our relationship, and the fact that we overcame that really showed me that there's a high chance that you're the one.
Did Aunt have to ask your parents before he married you? Am I the only one who still has this in the family? Yes, he did.
Yeah, so I was with Anna's dad about like 2 weeks before I proposed to her. And it was just me and him. And I did my best to ask him in Spanish. So I did ask her parents before I went to go marry her.
So who fell in love first? You did.
Okay. You got me. I was the first one to say I love you. So I don't remember exactly where it happened, how it happened.
Really? Yeah, in high school.
Yeah, high school.
Are you guys planning on getting a dog? What breed would it be?
Okay, so
I want a dog! Let's get a freaking dog! Let's go dog shopping next week, baby. Let's go dog shopping tomorrow!
Babe, come on. What kind of dog would you buy?
I want either a poodle or...
Nah, straight. A poodle?
Yeah. Poodles are cute.
So, I like dogs.
And I like the ones that have, like, the wrinkles in their face. They're like
those
this.
Those are nice. Those are
that
cute.
Are like that.
Those are cute. I like dogs, but I like tigers more. So, I plan on getting a tiger one day.
We're not getting a freaking tiger. We're not. Anthony thinks he's going to get a tiger. This is not Carol Baskin. This is not... what's his name?
It's going to be all white.
What's his name, though?
Let me tell you how my tiger's going
to be. But what's his name?
Let me say how my tiger's
going to be. But what's Carol Baskin? What's his other name? Jeff? Sit the fuck down.
Joe Exotic.
This is not Joe Exotic or Carol Baskin up in here, okay? We're not having a tiger in our house.
I want an all-white tiger with black stripes, and I'm going to put gold teeth in his mouth. It's going to be the best tiger in the world.
Guys, please convince Anthony that tigers are not safe, and...
If you raise them when they're little babies, it's all good.
And it could eat us when he's hungry one day. Right. I'm all for tigers. I love tigers. I think tigers are beautiful at the zoo and at exotic places, but not in my house. Not in my home. Not... under my roof where my kids are gonna sleep and I'm gonna sleep, because if that tiger gets hungry, guess who he gonna eat? Your head.
The food that I give him?
No. If you guys are having argument and fighting with each other, who will be the first to reconcile?
Me.
That is a lie!
It's definitely me. It's most definitely me. This guy, most definitely me. Don't cap. It's me. Whenever you have an argument, I'm always the first one to put my pride to the side.
You're lying! Yeah. I'm the one that puts my pride to the side.
No, it's me.
I think it's equal, guys, because sometimes I get a little prideful, sometimes he gets a little prideful. But again, back to what we said earlier, when you love somebody and you are 100% committed to them, being mad at each other can't last forever. It can't even last a full day, because a few hours being mad at each other, it's like something's bothering you. Like, when me and Aunt are in an argument and, like, he's mad at me or I'm mad at him, it's like it bothers me. I want to be good back with him because I love him so much, even though he gets on my nerves, but it doesn't last so long, y'all. So
yeah,
but I think we both kind of like reconcile.
Okay, baby.
What's your greatest fear?
Heights.
Mine is rats and
toilets.
I don't like toilets.
Toilets. If you get Anna, toilets. If you get, no, toilets in general. If you get Anna around a bunch of toilets, she's gonna run away.
I don't know why I don't like toilets.
She makes us close the door to our bathroom in our room because she's afraid of the toilet in there
at night. I'm not afraid of the toilet. Anna, I just don't nighttime, like before toilets.
We go to sleep, at nighttime before we go to sleep, if that door is not closed, she makes me close it because she's afraid of the toilet.
I'm not afraid of toilets. What is one thing amazing that's keeping your relationship together?
So one thing amazing that's keeping our relationship together is the bond that we have. Like we said in the beginning, we've gone through so much stuff together. We've grown together. We've learned together. We've built together. Just even going back right now and reflecting on that stuff, thinking back to that stuff, it makes me fall more in love with you.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Same thing with me. A lot of you guys have also been asking, when are we selling merch, baby? When are we selling
very
merch?
Very soon.
We're actually drawing down ideas of what we should do. I feel like I can stay another hour here answering questions.
There's still so many more questions that we have not answered. So for all you guys that we haven't got to your questions, we're really sorry. Our camera is about to die, so we have to wrap this up. But there will be more Q&As in the future, so stay tuned.
And also, one thing I forgot to say is, when are we having a baby? Because that was a question that I saw so many times. We're planning to have a baby probably in the next year or 2 years. Not too sure. Whenever God wants it.
2 years.
Notification shout out.
So today's notification shout out goes to Mariah Lopez.
Mariah, thank you for the love and support, girl. Yes, we love you.
Big shout out to Mariah.
Not only Mariah, but everyone else that shows love and support. Thank you guys so much.
We
My heart goes out to y'all. Guys, stay tuned next video. We're not saying it in this video, but next video we will be saying, which next video our upload is Sunday, so stay tuned, because Sunday we will be revealing what you need to do in order to win the giveaway. We are at 94K right now, but stay tuned because we are going to be doing a giveaway at 100K subscribers, and we will be giving away a freaking
iPhone.
Yes! So make sure you stay tuned for next video. because we will be revealing next video. We might do a little like challenge or something. I don't know what we're gonna do. All right, guys, we love you guys so freaking much, and thank you so much for the love and support, and we'll see you guys on our next episode, which is Sunday, and this is not a reality show, so I don't know why I'm saying episode, but we'll see you in the next video. We love you so much. Mwah! Bye.
See y'all later.